Hey there guys, what's going on? This is Buzzertech here and today I am bringing you guys this brand new tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm going to be teaching you guys on how you can make your very own channel art for your very own YouTube channel in Adobe Photoshop CS6, CC or whichever version you're using. So without any further ado, let's begin. So if you're making a banner for yourself or for a client, before even designing it, just think about it. What kind of content do you make, and what your channel relates to, like what content you make on your channel, or if you're making it for a client, ask your client what content they make. So if you make gaming videos, you can do is that grab some screenshots of the game you play the most, or you can even get any games and any games is screenshot and just put them up, and I will teach you on how you can make that later in the tutorial. Or if you make something like vlogs or tutorials or pranks, you can do is that you can put in thumbnail of your videos in the banner, or you can put them up your selfies, pictures in your banner and even make it look. So let's begin. So first of all, you have to do is that go ahead and download the template from the link in the description. It's just a simple template. Once you downloaded it, save it and go to file, open Photoshop, and I'm using Photoshop CC by the way. So here's the template, banner template. Click on open and it will open this. Now you can see I have my watermark over here. Now you can do is that if you want to remove this watermark, you can of course remove it by just disabling it right here. You can do that. Now you can see I have no guides over here. Now to turn on the guides, you can do is that you can hold control or command on Mac and colon, so you'll have it right there. Or you can even do is that go to view, then show, and then guides. Yeah, so like that, and you will have these guides over here. This shows that you have to put up all your content of your banner in this very area, this transparent area you can see right here. You have to put it right here. You can see this very area. Okay, this area I have just filled right now with this color is for mobile devices. The banner is only on mobile devices, is only viewable to this part. The viewer on mobile devices cannot see this plus this part, like this part in total and this part in total. So you have to put all of your content in this, and it's our prime objective to put all the important content of the banner in this very area. So first of all, I would do is that I will just put up some gameplay screenshots. I have grabbed some Black Ops 3, GTA and FIFA screenshots, and I'm gonna put them up right here. So what you have to do is go to file, then place, and then just put up those. Just put them up, right? I have this screenshot over here. Okay, click on OK. You will not see that this if you don't have camera raw on. Okay, click on enter and you will have this right here. And once you have placed this, make sure your images are below this, are beneath or below this guide. And once that is done, just rasterize this layer and then file, place. And I'm gonna just put them up all those screenshots like that, and I will be back. Now, okay, you can see this picture over here. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just flip it up horizontally. So, how I can do that? Make sure the transformation, free transformation, is on by Control T and right click and flip horizontally. So, yeah, like that. And so, yeah, I'll be back. Okay, so now you can see that I just placed all these images right there. Now what I did was, you can notice over here that I just overlapped these images like this. You can see I overlapped it because I will be erasing this very part over here so that it makes a fade effect. So let's do that. Okay, but before doing that, make sure you are selecting all these layers, all these placed layers, by shift and then clicking on your mouse and selecting them up, and then right click and rasterize layers. Now this will allow us to edit it and then erase all the parts. Okay, so I will go to this image, that's this one, and I'm gonna press E on my keyboard to bring up the eraser tool. And now to increase the brush size, I will do is that I will press the bracket key on my keyboard, and it will increase my, or to increase the brush size of the eraser, you can go over here and just to tweak it up. Okay, so I will just erase this very part. Make sure you're not getting the opacity like this. You see here, you don't want that. You don't want this transparent layer, transparent background to appear. So make sure you're doing it properly. Okay, so once that's done, now I'm gonna go to this one. This is the Black Ops 3 one, and I'm gonna erase it like that. Okay, that looks good, baby. So now we'll be doing that. I will be putting up this all of these in I will be merging them up. So I will select them by clicking over here. Just go to the first image and to the last and hold shift and click on the last one, and it will select it all. And press on Control E on your keyboard to select all of these layers. Now I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna desaturate these layers to make a black and white effect. So to do that, I will go to image or adjustment and then desaturate, or you can even use the shortcut shift Control plus U. So I'll click over here and it will desaturate the whole image. So now I'll be doing is that I will be putting some motion blur over here. I will be doing is that I will just duplicate this layer by clicking on Control J, and make sure you have selected this layer. Okay, I mean you're on this layer, and then Control J and you will have a copy over here. Now go to filter, blur, motion blur, and make sure this angle is to zero and distance is around 1500, and click on OK. You will see this effect over here. Now I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna go to blending options over here and put it to overlay, and it will make it a bit darker, plus it will allow us to do some great stuff. Or you can even try some other blending options, or tune down this opacity and try it out. That looks good. But Control U to bring up the saturation, by the way. UN saturation option, by the way. Yeah, I will put it to blue and increase the saturation. So yeah, that looks good, right? Very well. Okay, now I'll be doing is that I'll be typing out some text now. So I will choose a font called the Bold font. You can get fonts for free from dafont.com. It's the ultimate way you can get fonts. So go ahead and grab some fonts and grab some favorite fonts of yours and get them up. Okay, I will be typing out over here. I will just change the color of the text to white, and I'll put some, I will make sure it's in the center. Okay, like that. Very well in the center. Now, I'll be doing is that I will be adding some layer style to the text. How I can do that? I will just double click on the text layer, and I will go to drop shadow. I'll put up a little of a drop shadow, very little. Okay, put the distance to zero, and put the spread up to around 10 or 12, and put them up like that. Now I'm gonna go to the gradient overlay. I'm gonna click on the gradient, and I'm gonna go to this one, and I will just change the black color to a little bit like a grayish color. Okay, so now I'll change the opacity to around like this. Now you can even put satin over here to give some nice effect, and that makes it look much better. So now I'll be doing is that I'll be putting up some background textures so that it makes it even better. I'm gonna go to File, Place, Crunch Texture, click on OK. Now I'll be doing is that I will be stretching this up right like this, and like that, and then just place it over here and just overlay. That makes it looks awesome in my opinion, but it's very noticeable. The texture is very noticeable. So I will do is that I will tune down the opacity to around 25%, and that makes it look awesome, isn't it? Definitely it makes it look awesome. Now I'll be doing is that I'll be making a new layer. I'll be going to the gradient tool. I'll be clicking on here, and I will click on this one and change the color to black, and make sure you have selected this preset over here, foreground to background, and then go over here and put the background color to black. And I will be doing is that I'll be putting up here like this, and I will tune down the opacity very well like that. Or I can, yeah, like that. See, this makes a slight difference over there. Now I can do is that I will put some social media icons. So for that I will go to Google, and Google Images I mean, and I will download some social media icons, or you can even download social media packs. No copyright intended, by the way. Once you have the image over here, there is no need to save the image. You can right click on it, copy image, go to Photoshop, and then Control V to place that image. Now I'll be doing is that I'll be tuning this down. So Control T on your keyboard, and then just tune it a bit down. Make sure you know all the shortcuts of Photoshop, that makes it super easy. Now I'll be doing is that I'll be removing the white background. So how I can do that? Press W on your keyboard to bring up the magic wand tool, and make sure you've selected this Twitter icon layer, and just press in the background, white background, and you will see it has selected all of the white background over here. So I can do is that I press delete on my keyboard to delete the white background, and it's gone. It's awesome, right? Now I'll be doing is that I'll be changing the color of this Twitter icon. So how I can do that? I will click on this layer, and I will make a new layer. I will select the Twitter layer. Okay, so how I can do that? Click on this and right click, select pixels, and go over here on the layer 28, or the new layer I have made right now. I will change the foreground color to white, and I'm gonna just fill the color, right? So Alt delete on your keyboard to fill the color. And I will be doing is that I will be making the clipping art. Now right click on it and create clipping mask. So it makes sure that the background is only limited to the pixels available in the Twitter icon. So yeah. So once that's done over here, I will place it right there. Now I'll make a new layer. I'm gonna go to the elliptical marquee tool, and I'm gonna draw a circle right around this Twitter icon. So I will just drag a circular selection, and you can see it's selected right there. I'm gonna go to right click on the selection, stroke, and add a stroke of width around 5 pixels and color to white, or whichever color you want. I will pick up like gray maybe, and you can tune down the size of the icon like that. Just select both of this layer and Control E to make them one layer. So now Control T and just bring it down like that and bring it in the center. So you see our icon is over there. Now I will do is that I will just make the color of this background a bit different, like white would be good. Maybe white would be my option right there. And I can even make some like cuts over here, like using the pen tool. I can make it like this, make selection, and I will just delete some parts of it and make it look like it looks nice, right? Pretty much. I will put on my Instagram logo. I don't prefer the new logo. Instead, I will go with this one. I prefer the old logo still. I don't know why. I'll just grab this up like that I did this last time. Now I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna put in some particle effect. Now it's very simple banner in my opinion. You can, and now I'll do is that I will go to the brush tool, and I have downloaded some brush pack from SeSo. I will link his brush pack down below in the description. He has an amazing brush pack. Just select this popular background layer style, and I'm gonna use it very well. And I'm gonna make a new layer, and I'm gonna make something like this. Something like that. Something like that. Something like this. That makes it look super awesome. Now I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna tune the blending option to overlay, and we'll make something like this. Now put it below this grunge texture right there, and I'm gonna tune down the opacity to around 25. That makes it look super awesome, isn't it? Now I'm gonna put a particle layer down here, and I'm gonna tune down the blending option to around screen, and rasterize layer to just, and just turn down the opacity like that. It makes it looks good. Now you can notice that most of my content in here was in the mobile section, so it makes it available, it makes it viewable on mobile, tablet, on and on also on PC, so it's all good. And so yeah, it's very simple actually. I just told you it's pretty simple banner. You can put him up something like a tagline below this text over here, and you can work out and do some crazy stuff. Like you can put him up your logo and do some cool stuff. So this is the basic idea of making a banner. You can just bring up your creativity and make an awesome, impressive banner that your audience will like. And so yeah guys, that's it with this video. I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and I hope this tutorial helped you a bit, if not bit a lot. Then be sure to drop a like, and let's see if we can hit 35 likes onto this video, as I said before. And be sure to comment down below and let me know how this tutorial turned out for you. And so yeah guys, thanks for watching, bye bye, and I will see you in the next video.